Hello world, welcome to my channel. I am Sahil and today I am going to show you how to send MySQL database data in JSON format using PHP and then how to handle those JSON data like displaying using AJAX. So as you all know that JSON is a syntax for storing and exchanging data. JSON is a text written with JavaScript object notation. JSON is very lightweight syntax because it includes only text. That's why it is so popular syntax for data exchanging between server to client or client to server. So here in this tutorial we will see some function in PHP that how to convert array into JSON. So before going to start, you can see here I have already created a database and table inside this database, and I have already inserted some records in this users table. Okay, so let's quickly create a directory inside htdoc folder. So here I will create php_json. Now open this folder inside your text editor, and first I will create a file action.php. Now in this action.php I will fetch all the records from the database, and then I will encode those data into JSON format. Okay, so first we need to connect to the database. So for this I will create con variable, and I will use PHP object oriented style here. So I will use MySQLi function, and here we have to pass the parameter server name localhost and username root, password is blank, and database name is Ulfmania. Okay, now we have to check using this if statement con connect error. If connection get some error, then this function will call die, and inside this we can simply show a message fail to connect. Now here we can show the exact error message. So here just write connect error. Now inside this we have to write the query. So select a string from users. Now by using this query we are selecting all the records that is present inside the table and storing in this SQL variable. Okay, now I will use MySQLi prepared statement for this. So here I will create a statement variable, and now I will use connection variable, and using this connection variable I will call a method prepare and pass SQL variable inside this, and then I will use statement and execute this query. Now I will create one more variable result, and then I will use this statement variable, and I will call a method get result. Now this result variable will store all the rows that is coming from this query. Okay, so you can simply show this by printr function. So let's pass the result variable here and go to the browser and open this localhost php_json, and this is our action.php. so you can see here num rows is equal to 10, so we have 10 records and here it is showing 10, so this is fine. And so we have to show all the records that is present inside the table. So for this I will use while loop, and inside this while loop I will create a variable row, and using this result we will call a method fetch SOC. Now this will show all the records in associative array format. So now we can simply use this printr function and show the records. So you can see here all the records are showing. You can use this create tag before the rows, so we can show this in properly formatted array. So here you can see 10 records are displaying. Now we have to convert these array records into JSON format. So let's see how to do that. So for this we need to create a variable. Actually we need to create a variable that is a array type, and that variable is an empty variable. Okay, now here in this while loop we will use a function array push. Okay, array push, and here we will use this JSON variable, and here we will use this row. Now whatever the rows are coming from this query are going to this array. Okay, now here below we will just echo, and now I will use a function to encode the array format from JSON format. Okay, so here I will use JSON encode function. JSON underscore encode function will convert array into JSON format. Okay, so you can see here by refreshing, so we have a syntax error on line number 14. So let's see what's, I have forgotten the semicolon. Now let's see. So you can see now the array format data is now converted into JSON format. So it is now easier to handle the data in Ajax part. Okay, so let's go to the Ajax code. So our PHP script is done. Now we have to create a new file, index.php. Now inside this I will just use the simple HTML tags PHP and JSON as title, and here I am using Ajax, so I have to include jQuery library. So for this go to your browser and open code.jquery.com, and from this main file just click this and just copy this CDN link and paste here. Okay, paste inside the body tag, and now I will also create a div result. Okay, now I have just created a div, empty div. Now I will show all the records in this div. Okay, so now let's write the Ajax part of the code. So first we need to write the script tag, and inside this script tag we can simply write document.ready function, and now here I will write Ajax code. Ajax code. So first URL, so we have an file xn.php, so this is our URL, so just pass here xn.php. we are getting the data from this file xn.php, so we have to mention it here. Okay, now what is the type of data? So we can use get or post, whatever you want. So simply you can use this get method because we are getting the data, not sending the data. So if you are sending the data to the servers, always use post method, and if you are getting some data from the server, you can use get or post also. So I am using this get method. Now write success function, and here I will write a response parameter, and now I will create a variable where data equal to json.parse, and here I will just pass response. Now whatever the response coming from this xn.php is stored in this data variable. Okay, now using this data variable we can simply print or display any data. So let's see how to do that. So simply if we want to print the name, so here we just have to select the tag where we want to display. So we want to display in this div, so here we have to specify id here, and now our the div id has result value, so by using this id we can get using this html, and here we have to write data, and if we want to grab the data of record 1, then we have to write here data and big bracket inside 0, and if you want to print the name, so here we have to write the name. Okay, now let's check in the browser, it's showing or not. So just php and json, so you can see here the name of the first row is showing here. Okay, here you can see here. So if you want to show all the names, so for this we have to run a loop. So let's run a loop for I in data. This is the enhanced version of the for loop, so use this is better than the traditional for loop. Okay, so in this for loop we can just cut this, and paste here. Now if you want to show all the names, so here we have to pass just I, and here you can simply write br tag for line break, and now just refresh, so it is still showing one record, that is the 10th record. Why not all? So where is the problem? Let's see. Okay, so this HTML method will only show the last data of the record, so we have to use append. Okay, we have to use this append method. Now let's refresh. Now you can see all the name from the table is showing here. You can just put this into any HTML tag, like if I want to use h1, and let's here just close the h1 tag. Now let's refresh. So we have to just concatenate here using plus symbol. So you can see we have all the names in h1 tag. If you want to show the ID, so here you can print all the ID. If you want to print the email, then you can show the email. Okay, so this is working fine. Now what we want, what we have to do if you want to show in a table format. Okay, so for this go here and just delete this div and create a table. And inside this table, first let's create the table heading. So first column is for ID, second is for name, third is for email, and our fourth field is gender. Okay, now let's now here just delete this, and we have to use this tr tag and then td, then we have to just concatenate with data I, and our first field is for ID, and then plus, and again here we have to just close the td tag. And now here we just have to td for name, sorry, td and just concatenate this, and just copy the same thing, paste here, and just change ID to name. Okay, now concatenate this, and here here I will close the td tag. Now just copy the same thing and paste here. Now here we just have to write email, and here also just write gender. Okay, now everything is fine. Now we just have to change here table. Okay, now this time we are targeting this table, and these data will append in this table tag. Okay, so just save and just check here. So you can see all the details are showing in table format. For better display, just use border here, border equal to 1, and let's see. So you can see all the data are showing in table format. So this is for now, guys. If you like this video, then hit the like button, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.